So this is fitting kind of what we just talked about with the VCS F styles, where you can adjust that gullet plate on site by yourself or with the help of us, where we would, for this particular horse you see right here, where the left shoulder is bigger. Now this could be structural or could be muscles. Now, if the saddle is fitting right in the gullet and in the length, just like you said, but it's different on one side than the other, you have to think about what I just said about orthopedic insoles. Right? Let me see if I find, here we go. Here we have a foot of a human. Okay, so I heard when people rebuild or build robots, the hardest part is to rebuild the foot. Most of us are super ticklish on our feet because a lot of nerve endings are on the bottom of the feet. And they signal us which muscle, what joints, how to balance ourselves when we walk. So if one foot, the left, is a little bit different than the other, we talked about the arch here, okay? And if it's extremely difficult, it causes you knee pains or it causes you all kinds of things. Let's say your ankle is a little bit different because you sprained your foot or that's how you're born, okay? What if somebody suggests your shoes fit, the right length in the shoe, the right width in the shoe, just use a sponge on that shoe and use pads in your foot. Your bone, okay, your joint, your weight will squish the foam and it doesn't do anything. In saddle fitting, you know, there is a pad we call the Port Lewis system, what presses away. We've seen this all the time, even with shimming, when you have a horse what is bigger on one side, you're trying to do with soft foam shims, okay? Then what will happen, they compress and they create the opposite what you desire, okay? And they put a lot of pressure into the side. So we've seen that also with computerized saddle pads. You know, this horse will brace if you start shimming. You see pressure in the front left, front right, still goes to the right, pressure in the back, left and right, and then puts nasty pressure onto the spine. So what is the solution? If we can see with computer or saddle pads, if a horse is structural uneven, you see this is structural uneven. It could have a false rib. It could have unevenness in the bone structure or just muscles, okay? We don't know. But when we have pictures, especially in jumping pictures, where you see the rider flying off one side, he says, oh, I can balance myself, I'm good. So in the landing too, you can see how the whole time the rider is hanging on the left side. This poor horse, where do you think, you can see here now, reaches with the right leg forward, where's all the weight on the horse? Okay, it gets pushed left. Unless you sit in the center of your saddle, the horse's leg will bear the impact. Okay, so what is the solution? You need to have a saddle. You don't have to go custom. You can get, there's many, many good used laser saddles out there, what can be orthopedic adjusted on site. The used VCS F saddles, they're not existing yet. It's a too new of a product. But if you don't want to go new, there's many used laser saddles where you can, just like the Farrier, where you can, together with your saddle ergonomist, the saddle fittings expert, give that horse the bigger range of motion, what he needs, bigger space on the left shoulder. Pads and shim will not help you, unfortunately. Sorry, I can't sugarcoat it because technology, if it's the Port Lewis system, computerized saddle pad, it just doesn't work. Okay, it's a short fix, but it's not the proper fix.